I've always liked the packaging from this manufacturer. That means your engine's going to get to you in good condition. As a rope starter, this is an adapter to go in your cordless drill to start it. I think I'm going to open this one from the bottom. Nice clean looking engine. So you've got a notch here for the rope. This engine is water cooled. Put water in here. Needle valve. And this one has a variable speed carburetor, like for radio control. It's already adjusted so it will only close that much. Ignition wire up to the spark plug. And this ignition source requires a single battery. There's a magnet pressed into the flywheel here. And a Hall effect sensor is in there in about this position. And when that magnet passes over that, that triggers your spark for your ignition. This copper elbow just sits on here. You can direct the exhaust wherever you want. Both intake and exhaust valves are operated by push rods, and the rockers are under this cover. This is the intake valve, base of the carburetor is here, and the exhaust valve leads to the exhaust pipe. This is the rope starter that comes with the engine, and the notch in this pulley is pretty small, but you can get it in there. This is mason cord, what the bricklayers use to get things squared up with a level, run a straight line. Bring it in here, put the knot in the notch. This engine starts pretty easy, so you don't have to do this very often. When you first fill an empty tank, you're going to have some air in this line, and you'll end up doing this a few times to get the air out of there. My handle is a short piece of wood dowel with a hole drilled in it. I'm using Coleman lantern fuel with just a hint of Marvel mystery oil. If you watched previous videos, I think you can tell that that's a lighter shade of pink. I'm using a little bit less Marvel mystery oil. I think this is quite sufficient. I haven't done it yet, but I usually take a file and I'll file a notch in the needle valve so I can keep track of its position. I've marked it with a Sharpie, just put a little black mark on here. When they say tighten the needle valve, that means gently close this. Don't force it, and then open it about a quarter of a turn. When you go to start this engine, this carburetor needs to be closed all the way down to the smallest opening, which is the idle position. The crankshaft has flats for both flywheels, so you can loosen up the set screw and remove the flywheel on this side. Do not remove this pin. This pin is threaded into the bottom down here, and it is the axle shaft for a gear that runs in here. There's a gear in here. It's a helical gear, and it's driving one that's rotating on this axle. And on top of the gear is a cam for the intake valve, and on the bottom is a cam for the exhaust valve. So every once in a while, you can turn this up on end and use a needle oiler, dribble a little oil in there for the cams, the followers, and put a little bit on these two gears. I took this cover plate off the back. You can see the connecting rod swinging back and forth. This is machined from a solid piece of brass. I am going to guess that this is not sealed here, so it's intended to be a dry crankcase. Now that I have this open, I think I will drop a few drops of oil in there just for good measure, but not much. When you look at this engine, something looks crooked, but everything's straight. The tank only has a single strap on it. While I had this flywheel off, I took that strap loose and loosened this fitting, removed the needle valve, and took this piece off. Allowed me to take this fuel line off, and I put just a little bit of bend right in here. Put the tank back in place, and now it sits square. It still wiggles around a little bit, but that's fine. It looks like it belongs there now. If you're running this indoors, you need to be in a well-ventilated area. It does put out a lot of exhaust. This little engine wants to run with a load. This does get hot, but the water jacket's still good. The body of the engine where the cylinder runs is good. The head and the rocker cover gets hot. This idle is really nice, and if you put a load on it, it steadies out nicely. When it comes to timing the engine, you really don't have to worry about it. The set screw for the flywheel that contains the magnet, it matches up to a flat on the crankshaft, and those flats are directly opposite each other. So when you put that on there and you gently engage that set screw with the flat, you are automatically timed, and this is your Hall effect sensor down here. This is really a very nicely made engine. I have the starting adapter in my cordless. Set your cordless to high speed. Briefly touch the top of the carburetor and choke a little fuel in there.